Hi, I'm Jason Snell. I'm the editorial director at Macworld, and I'm here to give you a little bit of a preview of Siri, the new voice control system built into the iPhone 4S. To start Siri, you just hold down on the button on the front of the iPhone or on your Bluetooth or wired headset button. What's the weather like today, Siri?
Getting your current location. Here's the forecast for today.
Well, it looks good and then it looks bad later. Interesting. What's the weather going to be like in Chicago this week?
Here's the forecast for Chicago, Illinois this weekend.
Okay. So Siri can tell you about the weather, but it can do lots of other stuff too. So let's see what else we can do. Play song Time Immemorial.
Okay, playing Time Immemorial.
All right, so it can do just what voice control on the current iPhones do, which is play stuff from your library. But of course, it can do a whole lot more than that. Where can I have lunch?
I found 14 restaurants whose reviews mention lunch. 12 of them are fairly close to you.
Okay, these are Yelp reviews, but how about downtown?
I don't know what you mean by. How about downtown?
It doesn't always work. I want to have lunch downtown.
I found 3 restaurants matching downtown. 2 of them are not far from you.
See, now, the last time I tried this, this actually worked really well in narrowing my search to show only restaurants downtown. This time it didn't work so well. And this is one of the things about Siri, is sometimes the Siri software figures out what you mean and it's kind of like magic. And other times it doesn't really work that well. I think this may be one of the reasons why Apple called this a beta. All right, let's try some other stuff. Send a message to Dan.
Which Dan? Dan Miller, Dan Morin, or Dan Frakes?
Dan Frakes?
What do you want to say to Dan Frakes?
Hey Dan, period. What's up, question mark. I was wondering if you wanted to have brunch sometime, period.
I updated your message. It says, "Hey Dan, what's up? I was wondering if you wanted to have brunch sometime. Ready to send it?"
Cancel.
Okay, I won't send it.
I don't want to confuse Dan. I've already had brunch with Dan. So anyway, you saw two things there. You saw Siri take a command, which is, "I want to send a message to Dan. Ask me which Dan in my address book I meant," and then take dictation, which is a system-wide feature in iOS 5 on the iPhone 4S. Let me give you an example of that. I'm going to go into an app. So here we are in the Notes app, and you'll notice that there's a new microphone button on the keyboard on the 4S, and this is the dictation feature, which isn't really part of Siri, but they all kind of blend together at points. So here I can say, note to self, colon, new line. I need to make some videos about the iPhone 4S, period. They need to be done by Tuesday, exclamation point. And there it is. It figured out exactly what I wanted to say. Kind of amazing. Nothing that you haven't seen before in some other apps, and you Android users will also find this familiar, but it's nice to have that capability system-wide on any app in iOS 5 on the iPhone 4S. All right, let's go back to Siri and see what else we can make her do. What am I doing on Monday?
Okay, Jason, I found 3 meetings for this Monday.
All right, so there are my three meetings for Monday. Make a new meeting for Monday at 2.
Okay, I set up your meeting for this Monday.
What's the ultimate answer to the ultimate question of life, the universe, and everything?
I'm on it. Okay, here you go.
Ah, Wolfram Alpha tells us it is 42. Open the pod bay doors.
We intelligent agents will never live that down, apparently.
Yeah, Siri has a little bit of an attitude. Sometimes that can be pretty funny. Send a text to Lauren.
Okay, I can send a text to Lauren Snell for you. What would you like it to say?
Hi, exclamation point. When you're coming home from work, comma, can you stop by the store and pick up some milk, question mark? Thanks, exclamation point.
I updated your message. It says, hi, when you're coming home from work, can you stop by the store and pick up some milk? Thanks. Ready to send it?
Once again, okay, I'll just cancel it. My wife doesn't need that. We have milk. How do I get to Reno, Nevada?
Here are directions to Reno.
And it automatically opens up the Maps app with a instructions on how to get from your current location to wherever it says you want to go. It won't do turn-by-turn directions, though. That's important to note. You need a dedicated app for that. That's one place where Android has some default turn-by-turn directions. Apple just doesn't. You can use Google Maps, but it won't talk to you as you're going. How many career home runs did Henry Aaron hit?
Let me think about that. Would you like to search the web for how many career searching the web for how many career home runs did Henry Aaron hit?
And now it'll just kick me out to a Google search for that phrase. It actually searched for Hank Aaron. Right here on the screen, I can see it's 755. So not exactly hands-free once you go out to search the web. So it's sort of a guided search up to that point. Remind me to eat a donut when I get to the office.
Here's your reminder for when you get to work. It says, eat a donut. Shall I create it?
Yes.
Okay, I'll remind you.
Do I have any new mail?
You have a couple of new emails.
Read them.
Sorry, Jason. I can only read incoming text messages.
Alrighty. You are no help to me then. Some of Siri's features really work best when you are somewhere where you can't look at your phone, like in the car. Being able to send and read text messages in the car is huge. That's actually a really great feature. Others are more about saving time where you could do it tapping away and swiping on the touchscreen, but it's actually faster to tell the phone what you want and have it figure it out for you. And a good example of that are alarms and timers, which are tied in with the clock app. So here are two examples of that. Set an alarm for tomorrow morning at 5 a.m.
Your alarm's set for 5 a.m.
Ugh, that's so early. But, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. Set a timer for 3 minutes.
Okay, I started a 3-minute timer. Don't overcook that egg.
Nice joke, although actually I'm making tea.
I found a number of tea rooms. 15 of them are not far from you.
Well, this is the adventure of Siri, folks. It is better than a lot of speech recognition I've tried in that it doesn't seem to demand a very specific syntax. You can sort of mix things up and it'll still figure out what you probably mean. However, it is still a computer trying to figure out what you're talking about. And while it's in beta especially, it's limited to some very specific information sources. Now, I'm optimistic that over time, Apple is going to tie this in with way more information sources, different apps, and hopefully third-party apps at some point, which would be really cool. I'd love it to be able to read tweets to me and let me send tweets and, you know. For example, I'd love for it to be able to tell me the baseball scores, but that's going to require them to have third-party access to Siri, and it's just not there yet. It's still in beta. Apple's still adding access to some of its own tools. But, you know, I'm impressed. And it does figure out what you're trying to say. Even if you talk like Yoda, let's try this one. Go to the movies I wish to do.
I found 12 movie theaters. 11 of them are fairly close to you.
Interesting. Dinner I want to have.
I found a number of restaurants. 22 of them are fairly close to you.
So basically, if you're a small green Jedi master who has some trouble with grammar, Siri's also not going to be a problem. I think that's because Siri's really looking for the words you say, and it doesn't really matter the order, and then it's trying to figure it out. Well, if you'll excuse me, my tea timer just went off, so I am going to go take care of that. Again, I'm Jason Snell, editorial director of Macworld. Thanks for watching.